Hey folks, Ben from Stowers here today. I've got the 23Zero Outbreak swag.
Hit it.
It's made from heavy duty canvas, got windows and doors all around, a really cool sunroof feature. It's perfect for those who want the roominess of a small tent, but the durability of a swag. So this is the swag set up behind me here, and it comes in this bag here. Now this measures about 1.6 meters in length and about 40 centimeters across these dimensions here. And they say there's enough room in this bag to fit your sleeping bag in there as well when you roll it up. Now this is made from the same 400 GSM polycotton canvas that the swag's made of, and nice heavy duty straps that go right around the bottom of the swag, bottom of the bag, sorry. So it's nice and sturdy to carry it in. The zip runs up the side and across the top, so you can almost flatten the entire bag out, put the swag in there, and then pull the bag up over the top. So it's nice and easy to get the swag back in the bag. And then once it's on the roof rack, you've got nice big grab handles on the end, so it's easy to get on and off your roof. Now, you also get a bag of pegs with the swag, and they're nice heavy duty pegs, or reasonably heavy duty pegs, so you get enough to set the swag up there, just steel pegs. That comes in a little canvas bag too. And I will just mention, it does have an awning on the front here that we'll show you shortly, but it doesn't come with the poles for that, but you can get little swag poles like this as a separate accessory just to put out the front to set this awning up here. We'll show you a bit more on that shortly. Firstly, the fabrics it's made of. It's a 400 GSM proofed polycotton canvas. All of this canvas is the same material. It feels like a really nice, tough canvas. It doesn't have a ripstop in it, but it's got a nice tight weave and offers really good weatherproof properties, and it's also really durable. The mesh in all the windows and doors is 125 GSM mesh. So I wouldn't say not much is midge proof, but I'd say it offers a really good balance of durability and sort of not being too, or being reasonably fine, and offering or being able to see through the mesh comfortably as well. And then the floors are 550 GSM heavy duty PVC on the base there. It's all HF welded bucket floor, so nice waterproof floor on that. And on the very top, they don't specify just what this is made of. Well, it is a polyester, but they don't say what sort of weight it is, but it's a ripstop polyester tropical fly that goes over the top here. This just sits over the top of the swag. It's got little clips on the side here. They come around the edge, just clip onto the little hooks that go on the frame here. That goes around each side, out the end, so you can peg it out so it offers a bit more protection, a bit more rain protection. And then on the front here, it has this awning that can fold out. Now I'm gonna roll this out now, and then I'm gonna take it off because there's some cool features underneath here that I wanna show you as well. So all reinforced in the corners, bit of PVC there where the eyelets are, and this is where you can get your swag awning poles and just set this up as a little shelter just in front of the door of your swag there. And you can put this on either way, so you could reverse it and put it on the other way as well. Now I'm actually going to take this off now as I walk through the other features of the swag. And this has been a really popular model, and I've just got this set up in the shop here today because we finally had one on display long enough for me to show you all the features. So bit of a walk around. Firstly, starting with the door in the front, nice big storm flap here with overlapping flaps here, so it's nice and weatherproof. And when this is open, it can roll right up to the top here. So we roll this up. There are tabs here at the top to secure this open, and that then reveals a nice big mesh door underneath here. So you've got almost full coverage on the side here with that mesh. This then opens to get inside the tent. I'll just secure this up the top here before we come around to the end of the swag here. So I'll show you the windows around here before we get to this cool roof feature. Now there's a few flaps going on in the end here as well. You can see there's peg points that aren't put in at the bottom here. So peg all that out, nice and secure to the ground. Before I do this, actually, I'm gonna mention the frame. I haven't talked about the frame. This is an anodized aluminium frame that goes all through the tent here. All just clips together, so it is a very sturdy frame. It's not flexible. Well, it is a little bit flexible, but not flexible in the sense that the lightweight aluminium poles are. But this all clips together, and then you've got this extendable ridge frame here that spreads the two hoops apart. So a nice sturdy frame. Back to the windows on the end here. We've got this flap that sits over the top. We undo these two zips on the side here. We have got a second little gusset in underneath here. So if we do that up, we can actually peg this out as a little gusseted stormproof window on the end here. If we undo both sides and roll this up, we've got another layer underneath here. So you can see how weatherproof this is. We've got two more layers still. I'm just going to do one side there. So you can secure that to the top. That can be set up out here with this open underneath if we like. That offers weather protection over these zippers. If we unzip this one, this allows us, if say it is really, really wet weather, we can have this sort of half open to allow ventilation up here. This top one can come over the top, and we've got protection here from any sort of splashing if it is really, really wet weather. Alternatively, open this all the way up. You've now got that 125 GSM mesh panel there, and that opens as well, so you can actually access the tent from the end here if you like, so that goes straight inside the tent. We'll come around to the back here. I'll probably just describe it to you. I don't know if we can quite see, but this is exactly the same as what we saw on the other side there. So we've got full length flap at the top here, full length mesh. This is a door as well, so we can access it from this side. And if that fly was on, we wouldn't have the awning on this side. We'd only have the awning on one side, but we can reverse that fly around. Around to the other end here, mirror image of the opposite end, where we've got this flap over the top, which is gusseted, so we can peg this out as a gusseted window to allow airflow, and those two panels underneath there as well. Now, if we just come around to the front, I'll step inside the smoke shortly, but first I want to show you the skylights or the roof vents on these. So this one here is open at the moment. So we've got this mesh panel here that if we're not, you don't have to use the fly. Without the fly, it's quite waterproof. The fly offers extra water protection. But this zips closed, and you've got two flaps overlapping each other here. Zip that up, and we've got a closed roof on there. So wet weather, that's going to keep you nice and dry. If you want to allow more ventilation in the top of the tent, say in humid weather, or if you are on a dry night and you just want to be lying down stargazing or seeing the shape of the trees against the moon, roll this up. Now this feature here is mirrored on the other side here as well, so this skylight features on both sides of the tent, so you can almost open up the entire swag if you do the windows at each end, the doors on each side, and both roof vents. You've got mesh all around, and you've now got this big full-length mesh skylight in the top here. Furthermore, I'm not sure when or why you would need to do this, but that opens as well. I guess doing that allows you to close this from the inside of the tent. So if you wake up or it starts raining during the night and you've got this open, you can unzip this, reach out, do this top panel up, and then do the mesh up underneath there as well. So every side of the Outbreak swag opens up and allows you to almost like a full mesh, a sturdy mesh sort of shelter if you like. But if you zip it up and put the fly sheet over the top, you've got a really weatherproof shelter. And before we jump in, dimensions of the swag. On the outside, it's probably about 230 centimeters from sort of the furthest peg point at each end, and about 150 to 160, or 155 to 160 centimeters in width, sort of from the outside of the frame to the other side. And the very top here, around about 105 to 110 centimeters on the outside. Inside is a little bit different. And if we have a look straight inside here, we can see we've got, I'll just zip this up, a high density foam mat. It's a seven centimeter thick mat that covers the entirety of the inside of the swag here. Now that will roll up inside the bag as well, and if you left a sleeping bag in there too, you'd get the sleeping bag in there with it. So nice thick mattress here. I'll have you sit on that, let you know how comfortable it is. I mean, I wouldn't say it's the densest or heaviest, heavy duty foam, but once you lie down flat on here, it's really comfortable. And if you have too heavy a duty foam mat in a swag, it's really hard to roll up. I think this, I'm sitting on this now, it feels quite comfortable. The space inside the tent, it's actually 215 centimeters from the end here up to the very end here. Now I'm 185, so lying down here, I've got tons of space, and the ends of the swag are reasonable. They're not upright, but they're not so sloped that you've got a tight triangle at the end of the swag. And 150 centimeters in width from this end here, this edge to this edge. The mat is tapered on the corners. I'll show you on this opposite corner here. You see it's got a taper on the corner here, so it fits neatly in the corners of the swag, because it does have angled sides on it. It's not a square at each side there. And headspace inside here, it's about 90 centimeters by the time you account for sort of a little bit of sag here. So 185 centimeters total height, but I can sit upright here with probably about 5 centimeters of head clearance here. So that height extends almost to the end of the swag here. It's almost sort of like I can spread out from one end to the other with my arms before it starts to slope down. So heaps of room to sit in here. And if you've got two people, you could both sit up each side of the swag here and have a bit of head space. So enough room, clearly an easy enough room for two sleeping bags, a little bit of gear, people to sit up, or you and your dog have got heaps of space in here. So quick look at the other features inside. We've got on this end here, just a little mesh pocket. kind of sits down underneath the mattress, but it's a good place just to keep things so they don't get lost. Moving across from that, got that end door there. As you can see, you can access all three flaps, the top one and the two here, so you can zip up or do them up, undo them while you're inside the tent. Above that, you might not quite be able to see it, but there is a little sort of plastic, what is a plastic ring here, so you can hang a lantern, if you like, off of that guy there, and that goes straight up to where the frame meets at the top. Actually, while I'm here too, I'll just point out that this is all seam sealed on the inside here as well. I don't know if you can see that in the video, but all of these seams here have got seam tape on it, so the swag itself is weatherproof. You can season it out of the box if you like, you don't have to. It's weatherproof straight out of the box, but this is an extra step they've taken to make sure it's weatherproof on the seams there. Keep moving around, another storage pocket, same as the other side here. You've just got them at this end, not at the foot end. And moving on to this side, that door that I showed you on the outside there, I can open this from the inside to access to close that door on the outside. At the far end here, another door, just like we had at the opposite end, all accessible from the inside of the tent here. So unzip that, I can access the mesh panel on the outside. And then most importantly, the sky roof on top here. So you can see I can unzip this and reach outside the tent here, so I can undo this mesh panel on top here, So this side's open at the moment, this side we've got closed, so I can access this side here, reach the mesh panel up under here, zip it up if I like, and make sure I'm bunkered down and nice and weatherproof. That is the Outbreak swag from 23Zero. This has been a really popular swag. We've had heaps of video requests. We've only just been able to keep one on display in the shop long enough for me to actually do a video on it. I think it's a really durable, well-made, and somewhat bomb-proof shelter. If you're looking for something that's kind of tougher than a tent, not as big as a large sort of family-sized tent, but offers the durability and protection of a swag, the Outbreak's a good option for you. Check them out online at snowies.com.au where you'll find them at our lowest prices every day. If you've got any questions, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel full of our latest info, or check out some other 23Zero products like these ones down here.